Bit of a break. Right, now if you can see, because we used the treatments, all that fat has now cooked out. Now, we don't really want that in our foods. So what we're gonna do is drain everything off in the colander and then put it back in. So. Sorry, just a humble little kitchen. I don't know that. Drain it all off. Can you see everything is dripping out? So we've got, so it's not only, it's healthy too, okay? Once you've realised all the fat has gone, put it back in your pot. Now before we put it back on the heat, if you put it back on the heat now, it's all going to burn because there's no fluids in that. So from a point of view here, I'm sure you can recognise this. I'm going to add my chopped tomatoes. Straight in there. Without the lid, obviously. I'm not a chef, I did mention that. Back on the heat. I'm going to give it a good stir around. So the only juices now are from your tomatoes. Part of your five a day, by the way. Now this is where we start to add our flavourings and seasonings. Now I always, always put a little bit of salt. Not too much, just to give it that bit of a kick. Always put pepper in. Again, cheapo pepper. Pepper's pepper at the end of the day. Put it in your hand first because you don't want to over pepper. And just, that's it. Sprinkle that. Smells delicious. What do you think, Mr. P? He's nodding. Are you nodding? He's nodding. Give it all a good mix. Now you don't have to add the mushrooms, you don't have to have the bacon. This is my daughter, my grown-up daughter's actually come around for dinner tonight. This happens to be her favourite dinner, so that's the reason why. Now I tend to put, if you have it, some ground cumin. If you don't have it, it doesn't matter. It does bring out the taste of the beef. Cumin always brings out the taste of the beef. You can get it quite cheaply and it will last for months in your cupboard. Once you've got herbs, you can just keep them and that's it. You don't need to buy it again. So we're going to add just a tiny, tiny bit of cumin just to bring out that flavour. Not too much because we still want it to taste a little bit Italian. And then the cheapo mixed herbs. You can't go wrong with mixed herbs. Once you've got mixed herbs, you can use it in a lasagna, bolognese, anything you want. Generous, generous with those. Can you see, Mr. P? Can you see how much I've put in? That's quite a generous amount, okay? Yeah, coolio. A good stir. Now, I know what you're thinking, I haven't put any stock cubes in. Okay? I haven't. No, I haven't, because I've actually run out and I can't get any more now till I get paid. So, what I'm going to do is use good old fashioned gravy granules. Again, very, very cheap, value supermarket. Let's go for it. And this doesn't only thicken the sauce, it adds that depth of flavour, okay? So Mr. P, if you can come in a bit closer, then you see what I'm doing. Thank you. I'll have to do this left-handed now, won't I? And don't forget, in cooking, you can add, but you cannot take away, so go easy. Because you don't want it to be too rich, especially if you've got little ones. Stir it all in. Smells wonderful. absolutely smells delicious. And this is where we do the taste test. Okay, where's my little spoon? Oh, I put it back in the drawer. There we go, my little teaspoon. Oh, that pepper's gone up my nose. Take a little bit of the sauce, just a tiny bit. That's a good bolognese. That's a good bolognese. Mmm. Now what I'm going to do now, to make sure that all those flavours cook in, is just turn it right down till it's barely hot. Number one, I'm going to cover it with a lid, and that is now going to simmer for a good hour, hour and a half, to let all the, and also because you're using the cheap mince, sometimes the beef cuts, the cheaper beef cuts are better if they're slowly cooked. So this is why I'm doing that. So when you do dish up your bolognese in an hour's time, you will, the beef mince won't taste as stringy or anything, okay? And if you need to add more to it as you go along, please keep testing, okay? Now, spaghetti. Now we all have Litlands, and when they're tiny, they like to sort of, they spin it round their forks and they spend ages doing that, and by the time they've got to it, it's flipping cold. And then the spaghetti drips down their top and you've got bolognese stains. So this is a little trick I learned. Where's it gone? Cheapo spaghetti, again, it all tastes the same, it's all spaghetti. Take it out of your packet. I never measure it. If I've done too much, then I just freeze it, it's fine. And what I do is split it in half. Not only is it easier to cook, it means that Litlands, instead of spending like 10 minutes winding down one fork, you know, it's like straight in their gobs, which is what they want. Because all kids love spaghetti bolognese. And then you just boil it up 10 minutes before your bolognese is done. Bit of grated cheese if you have it on the top. If not, a certain value supermarket sells a nice big block for about £3. So that's it. That's my home cooking for today. And I really hope you enjoyed it. And I'm going to be doing a roast chicken plus soup with tinned vegetables. Nothing wrong in that. I'll see you soon, guys. Bye.